Hello everyone, welcome back to Emstine TV. In today's video, we are going to Ghana and Nigeria. What are we going to see here? Some people have complained that this comparison doesn't help us in any way. Please, it is not that we are looking down on some countries. We are only answering questions which are being asked. Any question that is being asked, the answers must be provided. So what are we going to be seeing in this video today? Which is the most English speaking country between Ghana and Nigeria? This is a simple question that was asked, and many people have given their own point of view regarding this question in different ways. So you are also allowed and you are most appreciated to share your own points of view concerning this question in the comment section. Which is the most English speaking country between Ghana or Nigeria? So thanks to my channel subscribers, you guys are all amazing, and if you are new to the family, please do consider subscribing and turning on your notification bell. The question has two answers depending on how you interpret it. The first one is, which is the most English speaking country relative to its population? Which is the most speaking country between Nigeria and Ghana? So far as population is concerned, Ghana or Nigeria? The answer is Ghana, because Ghana is less populated than Nigeria, and majority of them, as explained to this video, is as we are going to hear and listen here. Ghana has an adult literacy rate of 76.6%, while Nigeria has an adult literacy rate of 59.6%. Hence, relative to the population, more Ghanaians speak English than Nigerians. That's all right. Wrong. Niger no dey carry last. We accept. Ghana has a population of close to 30 million, of which 77.2% are adults, that is, as from 15 years and older. With an adult literacy rate of 76.6%, the number of literate Ghanaians adults are as from 18 million. Including English speakers who aren't literate, the number rises to 20 million. So that is it about Ghana. Nigeria, on the other hand, has a population of around 200 million inhabitants, with 58.17% of which are adult, that is 15 years and older. And with an adult literacy rate of 59.6%, the number of literate Nigerians adult are as from 70 million. Including English speakers who aren't literate, it becomes 80 million English speakers. So to the second question, which is the most English speaking country by population of English speakers, Ghana or Nigeria? The answer is Nigeria. So that is it according to this individual perspective of answering the question. We move to the next person to hear what he has to say. A study conducted by World Linguistic Agency has rated Uganda the best English speaking country in Africa. This comes in the wake of a video from a Miss Rwanda contestant that was shown struggling with English in a country that made a move from Francophone to Anglophone. After Uganda, the following countries came in closely: South Africa, Nigeria, Kenya, Namibia. Despite their strong traditional accent, Nigerians were credited for taking the spot for constructing good sentences that are grammatically flawless. So we have the list of top 11 most English and best speaking in Africa as follows. 1. Uganda. 2. South Africa. 3. Nigeria. 4. Kenya. 5. Zambia. 6. Botswana. 7. Zimbabwe. 8. Malawi. 9. Ghana. 10. Rwanda. 11. Sudan. Those are the top 11 best English speaking countries in Africa as per this answer. Someone asks, with all these studies, why are Nigerians still made to take the IELTS or other English language exams for the purpose of immigration to some countries? So despite Nigeria being among the top 10 best English speaking countries in Africa, an IELTS exam is still requested from its citizens in order to migrate and studies or work in other parts of English-speaking countries in the world. That is it. We move to the next person. Literacy rate show the percentage of the population who can both read and write. I'm assuming one must be able to speak the language if one can read and write in it. This came after a question was asked. Is the question about ability to read or ability to speak? And someone just responded, literacy rate shows the percentage of the population who can both read and write. I'm assuming one must be able to speak the language if one can read and write in it. So we move to the next person to hear his own answers. We are not talking about literacy level. We all know that many Nigerians in the northern part of the country are literate, but it's not in English. They studied Arabic and can read and write in Arabic, and that doesn't translate to them being illiterate. Including those northerners to the literacy figure of Nigerians, we shot up the percentage. The whole literacy argument is flawed. Many people can read and write but can't communicate fluently in the language. I can read and write many languages, including lots of Romance languages, but find it difficult to communicate with them. That is his own point of view. Is the question about literacy or English speaking? That is someone who is asking that question, and someone says they are both English speaking countries. Which is the most French speaking country, Belgium or Switzerland? Another person pops up with another question. A very good analysis. I wish to add that since 1990s, Nigeria had many Ghanaian English language teachers in her schools, especially in the south, a fact that proved their quality. My uncle hired when I was preparing for my GCE exam, that is the General Certificate of Education exam back then. However, I believe English is more spoken in Nigeria than Ghana. For example, most Ghana TV stations broadcast in their local languages. I appreciate that, unlike in Nigeria, where English serves more as lingua franca. But when it comes to accent, Ghanaians are way back compared to Nigerian. Someone says, Ghanaians don't speak the English language more than Nigerians. You can only find about 60% of Ghanaians that live in their capital city, Accra, speaking or can actually use the English language properly. But when you leave the capital city to other towns and cities, you find it very difficult to communicate because majority, at least 80%, don't know how to speak the English language. Though most understands if you speak, but they find it very hard to reply. I did a research, a small one, and discovered that they are not used to English language in majority of their schools. They use their local languages. That is why Ghana, almost all of their radio stations use their local languages rather than English language. Really, you know very well that what you are saying is false. I can tell you on authority that every school in Ghana uses English and not their local languages. It's even a debate as to whether kids should be introduced to the local language or not, because they perform badly in their local language and wait. In the 16 regions in Ghana, the central region is considered the most literate region with the best schools in Ghana. Please come again. In contrast, I have been to Ghana on numerous occasions, but from my experience, I think Ghanaians speak more Asante language than English. It's only when they come across foreigners they used to speak English. English, contrary to widely held belief, English is more spoken in Nigeria because of the ethnic diversity. That is it. And another person says, all these stories and statistics just for a simple question. Of course, Nigeria speaks English more than Ghana. I have lived in the two countries and it's definitely Nigerian. Forget all those statistics and all. In Nigerian, you don't have to be illiterate to speak English because your environment subconsciously teaches you. So that is it about this video. Please do share your own points of view as concerning this question. Any question that is going to be asked on this channel, we are going to research and bring forth the answers. No question is useless and no comparison is useless. If it is not worth researching, we are not going to come with any answers because we are not going to look down or propagate against any country or against any individual. because we gain nothing by doing that. Till next video, please do consider subscribing and turning on your notification bell. Till next video, stay blessed. Love you all.